back, everybody. So we got a whole bunch of rubber lines to put on, and then we can put the valve body mount up and get it welded, and then figure out how we're gonna mount the valve body to it. So stay tuned and we'll get some more done on this. Woohoo! So we're gonna hook up this one, and that one, and then get the steering ram in. We still have to grind that flange down to get that to fit in so we can get the pin in. And we got all our hoses. Oh, do we have a shitload of hoses? And then we got the valve body in the box, and then we'll get that mounted, and then we'll go from there. All right, so we're gonna get that valve bracket all ground down, and we'll get the pin in. Get to the valve body and see how we're going to mount it to this bracket if we need to modify it. I guess where we're gonna put it is here. This up here is not gonna work, so we'll just cut those off. Drill two holes, put this big valve body in, because we can set it this way or this way, because it's got double bolt holes on the top of it for the way you want to run it. I think I want it upright. That way all the hoses are facing forward and not up and rolling over. I think that'll be a neater feature for it. Okay, so we got the bracket all cut. So now we're going to drill that hole and the one that's over there. And then we'll find some bolts, get it bolted. And then we'll weld it in to that section. We can start connecting all our lines. Woohoo! We'll have hydraulic hoses on it finally. Hey, we got the two holes drilled out. And of course, this is my longest bolt. And I only have one. And it doesn't go all the way through. Like, it's so short. So, I'm going to have to get two long ones. So, for right now, I guess we'll get this welded in. And just wire tie this down temporarily. So we can put our hoses on and shit. So we know where everything needs to go as we're going. And then we'll just get new bolts next time I go out. So... yeah, one more thing I needed to get, and I forgot. Oh well, I thought I had bolts, but it is what it is, so we'll get that piece all ground down, and then we'll get the legs welded on so we can have that in the spot it needs to be. Okay, put the valve body on. Now we'll put our levels on. Alright, so we got the first hose on for the thumb bucket. Now we'll get the second hose on and ran up, put into this socket. Whew, it's definitely hard not having actual swivels. Like, these are really tight fitting, so I gotta have a pair of pliers here to get this to turn to get it on. But we'll get it done. We've got one cylinder almost done. Alright, so we got the next two lines on. Now we're gonna get this one on. So we're just working our way down. So all the bottoms will be outstroke, all the uppers will be in stroke. So bottom, top for the hoses going in. So everything pushing forward will push forward. When I pull back, everything will pull back. That way everybody's lined up. And then we're gonna have to make a whole bunch of brackets to hold the hoses in place so they don't move around and get caught on shit. But we'll get them all mounted so we know what brackets we need to break and how we're gonna hook everything up to support all the hoses. So we'll get this cylinder on and then we'll get that one on. Grab those hoses and get them on. So we got two on the bottom, two on the top, two on this one. Now we have these two and then the steering ram. So four more ports to fill up. Whoo, things are a lot of work. It's definitely gonna be fun making the brackets to hold all these lines in and shit, but for now we're just getting these in and control lever and then the cylinder for steering. So we are getting there. A couple more hoses. Almost all the lines on. Definitely been thinking about how I'm going to do the brackets for all these hoses. So now we got the steering ram in. These are the last two got to go in for everything besides like the dump valve and the pressure side. Those will be next when I put the motor and pump on and hydraulic tank. So we'll get these last two hoses in. All right, so we have three hoses left. We have two for the pump and tank, and then a return line to the pump tank. So we got the other 10 hoses all on. Granted, we haven't made the brackets or anything yet, but this is definitely a lot of hoses to do. It's not like the air box where I only have four inlets and not 10. So definitely way different. But we got our output and our input line still to put on and then run to the pump and the tank. So that will be next, getting the motor and the hydraulic tank mounted. And then we'll do something about the seat because I don't think I'm going to use that seat. We got some welds to clean up inside this square tubing, what side's on, because that pinhole is not lining up. I got this side, but that needs to be taken apart and cleaned so it slides in for the tow hitch section, what mounts to the three-point section for this unit. All our steering ram is in. All the other ones are in. Our thumb's in. Our thumb is still tacked together for right now until we figure out we got to have the machine running. I want to see how this all works while it's running. And then I'll decide if I'm going to, I think, cut this bracket off and then move it down or up to get this arm to swing in more. Not really concerned about it being fully all the way out and being able to grab something. That's okay. As long as it's like in the half position and I can still grab something almost all the way out. Like being out this far and picking something up with it like that. Like small stuff, yeah, not a problem. But the big shit, yeah, I'm going to be like just range in the middle, picking stuff up and moving it. But this is it for tonight. Oh, got a big jump on it. So, a couple more things to do. Okay, so we thought we got enough, like, bolts and nuts. So, we got enough bolts, but we need some more nuts. I've got two on this side what I need. I got one more here. See, these three are taken care of, and then I've got that one and that one, so I've got five more nuts I've got to get so I can bolt everything down. We are so close. We are getting there. So, hopefully, next couple of days, we should get a chance to start putting the motor and the hydraulic tank on and getting the pump hooked up. Seeing how everything's gonna work, hopefully next week. So stay tuned for that one. Woohoo!